first season of Can't Take My Eyes Off of You, and she's Canadian, and became a rocking champion that did make it to number one. And by the way, I didn't give credit off the top, the show was suggested by a tap head out there. His name is Mark Q. Smith, and Mark is M-A-R-Q. Smith, so thank you, Mark, for that. And you did a lot of research on this. Songs that didn't make it into the top 100, didn't make it to the top 40, the top 10, and I modified it by putting Canadian songs that did make it. So we're going to keep going out the song by Jerry Lee Lewis. He was born Jerry Lee Lewis. I remember he first came out. We were all very familiar with Martin and Lewis. You know, Jerry Lewis and Dean Martin. I thought, like, somebody's got to change their name here, but he had Lee in the middle, and so Jerry Lee Lewis made him who he was. This song is written by Otis Blackwell and Jack Hammer. It's the Elvis era of 1956-1957. Sun Studios in Memphis, Tennessee, with Sam Phillips at the board. And he's recording these four guys. Elvis Presley, Roy Orbison, Jerry Lewis, Johnny Cash. Amazing. So out of that comes this song written by Otis Blackwell and Jack Hammer. Great Balls of Fire by Jerry Lee Lewis. It was called Jerry Lee Lewis and His Pumping Piano. He pumped the piano so hard on some of these records, he didn't even have a bass player. His left hand was so heavy. So he had a drummer and him on this big piano and a guitar player. So this song made it only to number two. But in the first 10 days, it was out as a single. It sold 1 million copies. This is back in 1957. And overall, it sold 5 million around the world, making one of the best-selling singles in the world. Saving people like that, but at the time, I mean, rock and roll isn't really selling. This thing comes out and sells a million copies in 10 days, but it stopped at number two. Here's Jerry Lewis with Great Balls of Fire. Thank you. recently discovered by Justin Bieber. He was up visiting and he saw that song, I think, through a new video. The video that was very cute as well, with a chair in a garage. It was a garage door opening, there was a band in there playing the song. And so Justin took that back and hooked up with his manager, and it became a monster. It just took conjecture to all of it. It's really great when a Canadian helps another Canadian, but then helps another Canadian and things like that. It's really good. Here's a song, and you'll be amazed at this. The Beatles, May of 1970. It stopped at 41, so it never even made the top 40. The position you make on the charts depends on many things. By the time if people are sick of you and hearing you and you're naming your song, and you've had 9 number ones out of the top 10 back in the early 60s, by the time it gets to 1970, there's other people in there competing for the top. So the Beatles, this song, Long and Winding Road, written by Lennon McCartney, stopped at 41. It never even made the top 40. So we'll give you two. Back to back, we're going to have Vancouver's own Terry Jack with a song written by Jacques Brel that Terry took and adapted. There's a number one song in the world, sold 7 million copies, and it's called Seasons in the Sun. So here we go with Long Winding Road.